Virtuoso also gives us relationships with some pretty outstanding suppliers. And I had the opportunity to meet with Miss Lacani over here, Miss Heidi, at a Virtuoso meeting, and I just really fell in love with the organization, and timing has finally worked out that we could get her here to Media Island with John. And we have some clients on a private jet with them this summer in Africa, and we thought it'd be fun to just kind of share it with some of our other favorites around town. So with that, I'll turn it over to Heidi Lacani and let her take you away.
Thanks,
Thank you very much, Angela, for, I know your mom for, since 1970s as well. It's good to see how you pass on to the next generation. That's the best way to do it. First of all, thank you for coming, taking your time to come and listen to us. I just want to tell, some people asked about myself and my accent. So I wanted to tell you, I was born in Iran, I'm Persian, but at a very young age, my parents decided my brother and I should come to the United States to go to the best schools. So we came and we grew up in Chicago. I was at 16 years old and my brother was 18. And of course, by the time we finished school, revolution happened and they told us, do not come back. And it was almost the best thing that happened because I had already an internship at a luxury travel company in Chicago, which were the original people who opened tourism in Papua New Guinea, in Easter Island, Bhutan, the second ones in China. So I just took this summer internship and I fell in love with it. And I didn't want to leave it. And now it's, that was 1975, and now I'm still doing it. In the beginning I said, as soon as I learn everything, Mom, I will leave. I'm still learning everything. And I'm, all of my team are from old-fashioned companies, and we were originally in for 27 years with Trafco, some of you may know them. And John Webby, our youngest member, he used to be with Abercrombie & Kin. So we pride ourselves, we were from really very old schools with a new face. We, in general public, I just want to share this with you. If you ask anybody what's the difference between a Timex and Rolex, they all know it. What's the difference between a Rolls Royce and a Volkswagen? Everybody knows it. But when it comes to travel, it's very difficult, even the best of the best. So as a tour operator, we rely for people like Angie and now the new generation, Angela, to be your consultant. They always say, well, what do you do? Well, we are specializing in what we do, but they are like your general practitioner. You know, if your toes are aching, they send you somewhere. If you want to go to Hawaii, they know who to. They are the matchmakers. So we thank you for bringing us here because we will never be able to talk to you unless it was for Angie, Angela, and yourself, Eric, and all the wonderful travel consultants that we have known for many years. Now, to introduce ourselves, we are known as Lacani because when I started in this business, I was so active and I loved it, and they have known me in the business as Lacani. When we started Lacani, we chose to totally connect ourselves with the top travel industry advisors in the country. And we are very fortunate to be here that Angela and Eric have invited us. Now, what we do, I just want to share with you how we do our product. There are so many tour companies. We don't do group tours. We do private travel. We design it for you. We put this brochure out. Some of you have it. And these are samples to go to these. Some people say, I've been everywhere. I don't know where to go. It's a good book to look at your leisure. It shows you, country by country, the most popular ones. If you put everything in a book, it will be this thick. So you will see, if you're going to South America, what are each country, what are the highlights. It has a map, it has the pricing, it has the season you should go. And then you come to Angela and Angie, and they will tell you how they can customize it for you. Because they know you. They know what's your interest. They know where you have been. So they will do that for you. That's a book of ideas. So then we custom made it to your specification. Now you're interested in architecture. Well, they will ask us to put more of that in there. If you're in food and wine tasting, they will do that. So basically that's the product in that brochure. Then we are very pretty much well known for our private jet tours, and sometimes it's to our disadvantage because they say, oh, those Lakhani people, they only do private jet tour. I'm not going to go on a private jet tour. But the reason our private jet tours, John will tell you more about it, that's his favorite product at Lakhani, is that the strength behind all of this is because we have been operating tours since 1970, some of my staff even earlier, to every corner of the world. In fact, when we started Lakhani, we decided to choose this logo. Truly four corners of the world. We normally say, if they're not fighting and you can get a visa, it's very hard because there are these things that it's like, okay. But as they close, some open. John had just done a Cuba recently, and we have been waiting for a long time. Not John. John has a huge passport, so he can go there anytime he wants. But anyway, the four corner also, we thought, what is the four corner besides the destinations? We don't do U.S., Canada, and Caribbean because you all know how to do that. You don't need us to design one for you. But across the world, we really, truly, if you don't know how to spell it, we have been there. So just don't say, do you do that? Now, the four corner also is our experience and the value we have. We have very good relationship. People all over the world really, truly know us. I was telling earlier to our colleagues here that one time we arrived in Easter Island, and this gentleman who, with his wife, were on one of our tours, he called John. John, you come over here. I go, yeah, what? He goes, you guys got the secret sauce. And we go, what's the secret sauce? He said, what is it? Everywhere we go, you start kissing the guy, and you're kissing the drivers, and you're kissing the staff at the hotel. And he couldn't remember why we were kissing everybody. Well, we've been coming here for decades. We know these people. And that was Easter Island, when that blew his mind. So that was really, actually, it's good because they know we're coming. If you're coming, we know who you are because of your travel consultants here. However, when we go there, it's not the first time you're sending someone there. So they know you are the kind of clients we're sending there, travelers that we're sending there. So that's one thing. And also, we're old-fashioned. We answer the questions, we're there, we anticipate ahead of time what you like. In fact, that's why we work through travel consultants, because ahead of time, they tell us, if you like dining at Michelin star restaurants, we already make reservations in advance for you. If you're into museum and you have special art, modern art, or whatever kind of interest that you have, we really in advance prepare it, so there's no surprises for you. And of course, our well-known, we say our integrity because we have been doing this as a team for four decades, so we are very much well-respected in the world. It's hard for me to say that. Now, the destinations. In this brochure, you will see samples of trips in Kenya, Tanzania, Morocco, UAE, just name it, anywhere in Africa. And if you don't see it, just ask your travel consultants. We will custom make it for you. We do also Asia, India, all over China, Japan, Vietnam, Cambodia, Laos. If you are going somewhere and we see you missing something, a lot of times people come to us, Vietnam and Cambodia. Well, if you have time, I'm going to put Laos in there because that's really a gem. Things haven't changed in Laos as much as in Saigon. So it's really the advice that we like to share with you. Here's Latin America, of course, that's Easter Island, and as John said, they do dance really better than that. Chichen Itza. This is again just a sampling for you to remember that we cover these areas. And Europe, of all the destinations in the world, Europe has so much. In the beginning when I started, Asia was my favorite. Then I went to Africa, then Africa was my favorite. Then I never wanted to go to South America. Then I went there and I saw they have mysteries of the world. Wherever I have been, they have it. And now Europe recently, because we, John is going to talk to you about this, recently we charter private aircrafts to go to places where commercial airlines don't go. And Europe has become, it's not just Paris and London and Rome, there's so much more to it that even one country like Italy is like eight countries. So at this point, I also want to mention that the last, was it like 5-10 years, I think, we are getting a lot of, that's why we don't do group tours anymore, because families come to us, two couples, friends, they bring their grandchildren. So our expertise is to design it for children. One time I had a family was 12, and they were from 12 years old, the boys were, and they bring their kids, grandchildren, friends too. And of course we have met them on the jet tour, and they say, yeah, they don't have to be swings and this and that, just put it for, design it for the children, the hotels. In fact, one couple, Abby and Charlie, told us, we don't want to be at the George Sank or Bristol Hotel in Paris. We want to be for where the kids can walk in and not be well-dressed and just casual. And it was wonderful. I think we did Intercontinental for them. So we designed it to the kids' interest as well. So in one day, I remember, the finale was in Paris. The boys were going to go bike riding at Bois de Boulogne. The girl's birthday, 18-year-old, she was going to go chocolate shopping and with her girlfriends and all of that. Grandparents went to wine tasting, and parents went to the museum. So we had to scatter the whole family of 12 to all of us. So just let us know what the kids like, and we can do that. I mean, what you said today, the kids rule.
Mm-hmm.
The kids rule. So now, all of this travel is wonderful. The part of the travel, everybody, even if you're on first class, you want to get it over with, is the flights. And we have solved that, and John is going to tell you about that. John, tell
them
about yourself.
Well, yes, another one with a funny accent. But mine comes from the fact that I was actually born in Africa, in East Africa. Heidi refers to me as the vanilla gorilla, which I have to do a lot of times. And between the both of us, with a Persian and a Kenyan running around in a rental car, you can imagine. We're quite a team. We know how to do this if we're going internationally, but when we're jetting all around the USA, quite an adventure for us. But it was a wonderful upbringing. I was very lucky to come to the US for university. I was at UCLA. So my whole sort of life in the US started in the early mid 80s. And then, as Heidi mentioned, you know, we both vicariously got into the travel business. And funnily enough, because I've known Heidi for 20 years, while she was doing wonderful things with the company Travcoa, I was busy with Abercrombie & Kent, and so we've known each other a long, long time, and so along with people like Angie, with Virtuoso, when it first came about, it was called API, we all sort of grew up in this wonderful travel consortium of people who really were just a huge extended family. So it's been a great ride. Heidi and I always used to nudge and wink and say, hey, one day we'll work together, not knowing what we were talking about. And sure enough, she founded Lakhani in 2003, and by 2008, I was like, I'm coming. And so it was a wonderful coming together for both of us. And our team in Newport Beach, California, it's truly a pedigree group of people who are so well-versed in international travels. And several of our team are also well-versed in luxury private jets. One of the reasons we're able to do this, of course, because the brochure that Heidi was talking about, the gold brochure, this is all about independent travel. So it's not about private jets at all. But this is the bread and butter of what we do. It always has been. And so our team in Newport Beach, I mean, this is really the big concentration. But from that, we're able, and with our past companies, because we did private jets with our former companies, we've able to continue this. I call this the cream butter of our organization. And we do the jet tours in two different styles. They've kind of evolved over time. You know, we were back in the old days, we were doing this huge lumbering L-1011. We used to take 80 people around the world. It was just amazing, and the trips were like 48 days long. And then once the L-1011 went away, we jumped into Concorde, and we all thought, wow, this is, you know, super new. And suddenly the trips were like, you know, 18 days instead of, you know, 48. And Concorde was this little toothpaste tube that we used to fly around in, and everybody hated the Concorde after the L-1011. It just wasn't like a proper flying experience again. And then we've gradually morphed into things like the 757 and the Airbus 321, and then into these regional executive jets that are just, they're beautiful. They're wide-body jets, which I'll tell you a bit about. So we do the two styles. We do long range, which is around the world. We do that once every 18 months or so. That's a part of our portfolio because of our pedigree. But that is always a long trip, and I'll get into that. It's always at least 23, 24 days. Because one of the ethos of Lakhani is that we always spend 3 nights in each place, so we get 2 full days of sightseeing. This is important, and I'll show you why. And so with that, the way we differentiate ourselves now from the likes of Abercrombie and Kenner Four Seasons is that we only take a maximum group around the world, up to 30 people, and 3 of us travel with the group. The reason we do smaller groups is because when you come to a private jet tour, whether it's around the world or Africa or Europe, you're really buying what is truly the best of the best. And so we guarantee that even on the ground, although you're using a private jet, even when we're in these beautiful hotels and resorts, you are in suite category accommodations, never lower than suite. So that's why we keep our group sizes so small, because even if you came to the Ritz-Carlton with 50, 52 people, they probably haven't got 25 suites that they can give you. They have got, 9 or 10 or 15 suites they can give you. So our ethos is whatever our tour is, the maximum number, and it's only up to 30 ever. Sometimes it's 24, sometimes it's 26. On the regionals, where we don't need the extended range, we don't need the long-range Boeing jets, we keep the group size even smaller. We go down to 14, and again, all guaranteed in suite accommodations. So right there is a difference. The around the world is the longer trip. It's always up to just above 3 weeks. And the regional trips, Africa, Europe, South Seas, Latin America, they're 2-week trips because we're not having to go all the way around the world, but we still stay 3 nights in each destination, as you'll see. One of the greatest concerns of people traveling anywhere is about the luggage. And many of you probably enjoy cruising. It's a huge crossover in our life. In fact, we jokingly refer to ourselves as the jet cruisers, because probably about 80, 90% of our guests on the private jets are avid cruisers. And so they're always wondering what's gonna happen with our luggage, how much handling of our luggage do we do? We call it luggage one touch. At the beginning of a jet tour, you bring your luggage to us in whatever the place is, we take it from there. Now remember, we're a private jet, so we're handled entirely different to a commercial plane. We don't go through commercial customs and immigration, we don't go through commercial security, we don't deal with TSA as such. It's all done privately. We're either at private airports, or if we're in a big commercial airport, there's always a private terminal, where they call it an FBO in America. Some of you might know that term, fixed base operator. So we always deal privately. So with the luggage, we take the luggage from you. We have special security tags. We do work very closely with FAA, of course, so we have special baggage tags, security tags. One of our team traveling with us is dedicated to luggage. So there's always a director dedicated just to the luggage. And once you give us your luggage, basically your luggage on a day of departure, usual flight time is anything from sort of 10:30, 11 a.m., we will collect luggage from inside your suite at about 9 a.m. It goes ahead of us by about half an hour, 45 minutes to the jet. It's loaded on board. We go slightly later. We just, through our private immigration, through our private facility to the jet, and we leave. Flights are in the short regionals, they're anything from 2 to 3 hours. Some of the longer flights on the world are 5 or 6 hours. When we land at our destination, which is always in the middle to the early afternoon, and I'll explain how that happens, then we go off for a short sightseeing trip. 2 tour directors take you in split groups. We go to see a welcome to the city or a welcome to the area. Meantime, the luggage transfers privately straight to the hotel and is put in the individual suite. So by the time we get to the hotel or resort about 4:30, your luggage is already there waiting for you in your suite. So you never ever have, there's none of this putting your luggage outside the door. There's none, you literally don't touch your luggage after you've brought it to us on the very first day of the trip. So luggage is something that we know how to handle in perfection. We've had some clients, very nice clients from Naples. In fact, they've been on their 3rd trip with us now. But the very first trip they came on, Dr. Lambert, at the end of the trip, we always ask guests for their input on what was their most favorite or least favorite of the trip. He said, "My most favorite part of this trip was how you handled the luggage." I said, "Dr. Lambert, we've just been around the world for 23 days. You cannot tell me." He said, "Well, yeah, that was all fantastic." He said, "I just can't believe how you guys handle our luggage." So it was a great accolade in luggage handling. Also, and I love Heidi's expression on this, fine travel is fine dining. It's absolutely true. We were using the analogy today with the team. You know, when you go to a place, you're staying in a beautiful resort. We'll use the Ritz-Carlton here. It's got magnificent dining rooms. But you're there for 3 nights. You don't want to come to Amelia Island and just dine in the Ritz-Carlton. You know that out there, there's places like Bar Zin, which we discovered last night, and we've heard about, what is it, 29 South? You've heard that there's great restaurants. Well, every city that we go to in the world, there's fabulous dining to be had. So you dine by choice. It's all included. Now, of course, we may be going to Singapore, we may be going to Cape Town, we may be going to Oslo, we may be going to, you know, wherever, Berlin. You may not know some of these restaurants. We know them well. So we're going to actually recommend to you, and before we actually travel, we'll be giving ideas through your advisor to say, you know, maybe they'll want to do a private dining. And this is what people love, this flexibility of you're certainly not dining in groups, and you're certainly not stuck to the hotel you're staying at. Everywhere, the dining is included, and it's a la carte dining. We don't know that beef or buffet word. It doesn't exist in our life anymore, thank you. Yeah, well, breakfast is about it. So, you know, this is, again, very, very unique to our company, because we know that, you know, dining around the world today is one of the most superb aspects of traveling. And so on the jet tours, it's always all included on an a la carte basis. One of the magical reasons for spending 3 nights, I mentioned, was that, you know, first day, we know there's lots to see. This is why we've come to a place. Of course, you know, we've enticed you onto this trip by some magnificent, you know, UNESCO World Heritage Sites, museums, palaces, these wonderful sites you need to see. So first day, we split into smaller groups, and we go and do our sightseeing. We do the key sightseeing on that first day. We do them in different orders, so we don't have all, you know, 14 of you going to the palace, or all, you know, if it's around the world, we don't have all 28 of you going to the same place. We split into smaller groups of like 14 each, say, and then go and do our sightseeing, all seeing the same places. On the second day, we have given you, prior to the trip, a small list of options. What would you like to do? What sort of things are you more interested in, those museums? Are you more interested in architecture? Are you more, would you like to get out, you know, into the wilderness? Would you like to go 4x4? Or would you like to play golf? Would you like to do spa massage? You know, we give you what we call choose your day. Again, you know, I think a lot of people think, well, when I travel on a private jet tour, I'm going to be sort of herded every day to do what they want me to do. Not at all. This is all about you enjoying your vacation time. And so every second day is choose your day. We have a lot of requests on day two for, I'd like a private guide to take us shopping today, please. So there's certain key spots of the world where shopping is definitively the second day option as well. But it's important to us for you to know that you've got flexibility in all the days that we're traveling. So just to clarify on the jets, because I think a lot of people do have confusion when we talk about a regional jet or an intercontinental jet, what are we talking about? This, the one picture that we use this one, is a Boeing Lineage, and we also use an Embraer Legacy 850. These are what I was referring to as wide-bodied regional jets. This is not a Learjet. This is not a small Falcon jet. Some of you may have experience with those when you're, you know, going from here to Aspen or here to New York or something. You know, you might rent them through NetJet or Privé, whoever. No, this isn't like a Boeing 737, but it's never known that it was a 737. It's the size of one. But we only have up to 15 guests in this jet. And this is what we use on our regional Europe. We occasionally use on regional Africa. So what you see inside, that the interior above actually is the Embraer Legacy. This is a 6'2" high jet, and the Lineage is 6'3" high. You're going into a jet that's extremely spacious. It's not a little toothpaste tube, as I call it. You know, people have sort of say, well, these regional jets can be pretty small. Not the ones we're using. We're going on vacation with them, remember? So, I mean, these are truly, you know, the best appointed what's available today. Every flight we do, whether it's in Africa, in Europe, around the South Seas, even around the world, and I'll show you later, we always do our flying in the middle of the day. We always incorporate flying over lunchtime, because it's the best use of time. You don't want to be getting up at 6 a.m. in the morning to fly to the next place. You don't want to be going at 5 o'clock in the afternoon and arriving in the dark. We take off around, you know, 10, 11, and we're landing at 1, 2 in the afternoon at the next place. I know some of you are thinking, how do you do that around the world? I'll get to that. But just so you remember, our ethos is always to fly in the middle of the day. And of course, some of the regional jet flights are pretty short. They're anything from 2 to 3 hours in length at the maximum. But this is, some of the interiors. That's the Lineage interior, in fact, the Boeing. Guests of ours, in fact, Fort Myers, Florida. And so, you know, when we go, we're treated, we're handled entirely as a private jet. There's no aspect of our trip that goes through commercial. Now, do you have to walk through a security machine? Yes, you do. Everybody does today. It doesn't matter. Just because you're a private jet, other airports have security requirements. But what you don't have to do is, you know, if you're carrying a bottle of water, they're not going to take it off you. You know, these are the sorts of things, because you're with us, you're on a private experience. But you can see these are very luxurious airplanes. And in fact, our clients are constantly saying to us, could you make the flights longer? We're like, we've never heard this. What's going on? But it's what people like to do. So, as I said, we categorize different trips. One of our most popular for the last 10 years now has been regional around Europe. And you have these have individual brochures. So you'll see them there on the front desk, and I think some of you already have them. Around Europe generally operates twice a year. You know, what are the best times of year? It's May and September. Well, I'm happy to report, sad for you, but May is already long sold out. It's been sold out for months. But we do have September available if anybody's interested in this year's September trip. And something that we've agreed with Angie and Angela is that if you are interested in this departure, we will also include for you, on behalf of the agency, a round trip international business class. So it would probably be from here to Miami or Atlanta and get you to, because these trips obviously don't start in the USA. That's a good point. The around the world trip always starts in the USA and comes back to the USA. But the regional trips start out in destination. Let me show you what I mean. So that trip in September, this is a nice brief itinerary for you. It actually starts in Oslo and it ends in Monte Carlo in Cannes. And so, you know, that would be, we will include for you the international business class air to get you to Oslo and back from Monte Carlo Cannes back to, well, it's Nice, back to the USA. This is it in a map version, because I love using maps with people. It gives you a real idea. These are places you just can't combine together by commercial airlines. When, you know, we have people look at these itineraries and go, my God, you're designing the most extraordinary places. That's what is efficient about using a private jet. Many of you have probably been to Europe many times. You may have been to some of these places, but to incorporate all of this in a two-week period and spending basically three nights in the key places is pretty extraordinary. One of the very great gifts of the private jet in Europe is that we can do what we call pop-ins. So you'll see here, we've come from three nights in Bucharest, Romania. We're actually going to Puglia in Italy, but we fly almost right over the top of Dubrovnik. Some of you may have been to Dubrovnik, some not. What we do is we take off from Bucharest about 10 in the morning. An hour later, we're landing in Dubrovnik. We have a wonderful private guided experience around old Dubrovnik, the old city, of course. That's about an hour and a half. We then take you out to a fabulous vineyard where we know the family extremely well. We have a magnificent, it's music and dancing, and it's lots of wine and great food. And then we're back on that jet by 4 o'clock in the afternoon, and we land in Puglia about 35 minutes later. So we just do a drop-in. We just stay for the day. We do the same thing on our way from Puglia to Santiago de Compostela, the most magnificent city in Spain. I mean, really a fabulous experience. But we fly right over the top of Bilbao. What's in Bilbao? The fabulous Guggenheim Museum. Who doesn't want to get to the Guggenheim? But you don't need to stay in Bilbao. So we're into Bilbao by about 11 in the morning again. We go, we have a private curator who takes us through a 2.5-hour tour of the museum, all the insider access that you don't get on a public tour. We have a private dining room in the museum. We have lunch with the curator, lots of questions, lots of great information. Off we go again, about 4 in the afternoon. And again, about 45 minutes later, we're in Santiago de Compostela. And then we're on to Cannes. We're doing Cannes right ahead, well, Monica, we're doing right ahead of the Grand Prix. I don't know if any of you have been, we happen to have been in Monte Carlo several times with the Grand Prix. It's chaos. The whole city is barricaded off because of the course. So we're getting there ahead of time before all the barricades go up, and we've got a very special treat for you because you'll do your own Grand Prix, but you'll do it in a slightly different way. I'm not going to give all the secrets away. So that's our September Europe. I'm going to run quickly through this Africa because both of these departures are sold out. I think what you're probably hearing now is, wow, you know, people really like these trips. People really do like these trips. And so this June 2017 was sold out. We have two departures going. It was sold out last year. The good news for you, if you're interested in Africa, and this is very unusual Africa, as you see, we are offering the same trip for June 2018, and we'll protect you at the 2017 price through the Wallace Pearson relationship that we have. So why is this an unusual Africa? Well, as you can see, it's quite a map here. We're heading out of East Africa, Kenya, my homeland, and we're heading out to the Seychelles, and then we're going into Madagascar to see the lemurs. We're heading into Tanzania, and then, of course, you know, great wildlife viewing in Tanzania, the Big Five, and then we're going down into Botswana, the Okavango Delta. So you're literally going from the rolling, endless savanna plains into the largest inland delta in the world, the Okavango Delta, and then a wow ending up in Marrakesh at La Mamounia for 3 nights. Remember, you're always in suites when you travel with us, even in Africa. Some of them are tented, but it's called Ritz-Carlton camping, I tell you. It's a pretty magnificent experience. So while that's not available for this year, it will become available again for next year. And there's a brochure with a beautiful cheetah on the front of it. It's also at the desk if you're thinking about 2018. What we have got available in Africa this year is what I would call classic Africa. This is operating in September. We actually only brought this one back because we sold out the other two so quickly last year. We thought, wow, you know, people are still wanting to go to Africa. So we brought back a very, very popular trip that we've offered for the last 5 or 6 years. And this one, again, will include, through Wallace Pearson, we'll do international business class air to Africa and back for you. But this one is a more classic in terms of highlights of Africa. If you haven't been to Africa before, this is truly a spectacular trip to go on. You're basically traveling, we're starting and ending in South Africa, so we start at the beautiful Saxon Hotel. We go immediately up to Singita on the edge of the Kruger National Park. Many of you may have heard of it, Singita Boulders. All suites there. We then take you to Victoria Falls for a couple of days. Then up to the Masai Mara. Now, you know, Africa, you've got to get to the right place at the right time. The reason we're not going into Tanzania in September is because the Great Migration by now is up in the Masai Mara, Kenya. So now we're going for 3 nights. We've taken over the beautiful Ilmoran, a luxury tented camp, all to ourselves. And then after that, by private jet, boom, straight to Namibia. I mean, there is no way of getting from Nairobi, Kenya, to Sosa down into Walvis Bay, Namibia. It would take you 2 additional days, 2 nights with all the flight requirements. In fact, a very nice travel agent, Virtuoso travel agent in Atlanta a couple of years ago, she had clients very interested in this trip, but they wanted to know, well, why couldn't we do this just using commercial planes? So she designed exactly this itinerary for them using commercial flights in Africa. It added 6 nights to the itinerary. I could go through this step by step and show you every single step of the way where it requires a forced overnight or even a forced 2 nights. This is the beauty and the efficiency of doing this by private jet. As we know, we were talking with Angela and Angie and Eric earlier, that what this is 2 very different trips to Africa rolled very conveniently into one trip, you know, 15, 16 days. So, you know, if Africa's on your radar, or if you've been to Africa, you're thinking you might like to go again, we have the opportunity this September to do the classic Africa, and then next year, as we said, we'll be running again the unusual Africa, which goes out to Madagascar. Some great shots of past trips that we've done. And then in terms of a more unusual part of the world, everybody's generally been somewhere in the South Pacific, whether it's, you know, Fiji or Australia or maybe Tahiti even. But we've, again, the aspect of having the private jet, we're able to put together a really unusual itinerary that incorporates, you know, not only the most popular in terms of what we've heard of or know about, but also the rather more obscure. So being able to go, you know, from Papua New Guinea all the way across to Hayman Island, which as some of you know is now one and only. It's just been reopened. It's a most fabulous private island resort. Straight into the center of Australia, the Red Middle, and into the Ayers Rock using longitude 131, which is a tented camp, of course. And then coming down out to Tasmania. I mean, we have so many people who call us on private trips saying, how do I get to Tasmania? I mean, logistics of getting to Tasmania are not easy. We fly it from the center of Australia straight to Hobart and spend 3 nights there, and extraordinary things to do. Who of you have seen The Lion, the new film The Lion with Nicole Kidman? It's filmed, quite a bit of it is filmed in Tasmania. You'll love the scenics. And then on out through Queenstown, New Zealand, again the 3 nights, and again ending up in Tahiti and Bora Bora at the St. Regis. Again, all suites category. And limited up to 14 travelers on this trip. So, you know, again, what we're trying to do is to join together places that some of which you have been to, but other places where, you know, it's all brand new to you. And in closing, I just want to talk about our next upcoming Around the World by Private Jet. Slightly different to what we do with the regionals in the terms of how we use a large extended range jet. We will actually, for this trip, be using a 757, a Boeing 757, usually takes up to 140, 150 people. We only take 30 guests maximum, as I told you at the beginning. So you've really got a real playground to enjoy in terms of traveling with us around the world. Quick overview of the itinerary, because again, you know, we keep every year having to come up with sort of new and exciting and different itineraries. And so in terms of what we're doing around the world, it's a 23, 24 day itinerary. And literally, as I said, starts out of Seattle and ultimately brings you back into Boston. So let's have a look at the detail of this. What do you notice, first of all? We're always flying in a westerly direction. A lot of clients get confused with this around the world business. They think it's many overnight flights. It's zero zip overnight flights. They also think, how am I going to handle this moving every sort of 4 days? What's the jet lag scenario going to be like? Well, let me give you a couple of examples. In terms of flying westerly, you know, predominantly west, we may have flights that go for 5 to 6 hours, but we're gaining at least, you know, the way I always say, think of New York to Los Angeles. It's about a 5 hour flight and you gain 3 hours on the way. So while you might leave at 11 o'clock in the morning, your actual landing time at the next destination is 1 o'clock in the afternoon. So your body clock is always on time because you're in daylight. You're not doing these over the water 16 hour, you know, oh, I need a sleeper bed type of flight because, you know, I need to sleep for 8 or 9 hours. Nothing like that at all. It's an entirely different concept. It's why we always go in a westerly direction. Even our start off flight, which is always our longest, but people love that because it's their first time on the jet. You'll see when we introduce you to the jet. Seattle to China to Harbin is about 11 and a half hour flight for us. We're an extended range 757, remember, and we've only got 30 people on board maximum. So when we fly that flight, we don't leave from SeaTac. We don't have to go to a commercial airport. Some of you know Seattle, and it's about an hour's drive down to SeaTac, and then you've got the mayhem of SeaTac. Nope, we leave right there from Boeing Field. It's a 15-minute transfer from our Fairmont Hotel down to Boeing Field. There's our 757 waiting. Zoom, we're out of there by, you know, 10:30, 10:45 in the morning. We fly that flight, but of course we're gaining time all the time. So our landing time in Harbin is about 4 o'clock in the afternoon. Now what your body doesn't know is you've crossed the date line. So you left on Saturday, but you're arriving at tea time on Sunday. But body doesn't know that. We have a fabulous reception planned for you when we arrive. We want to keep you up a little bit. You know, you've had a great time on the plane, you'll see why. But you know, this is how easy we make it. And then everything from there is much shorter. Even when we leave at the end, coming back from Marbella, that's about an 8 hour flight back to Boston, but we gain 6 hours on that flight. So we leave Marbella at 11 in the morning and we land in Boston by 2 o'clock in the afternoon. Everybody can connect in Boston. We work with a very private FBO in Boston. We don't deal with the international terminal. 757 just draws up at the private terminal. You're all off. We have private. Some people rent their own, you know, Privé or NetJet to bring them home. Other people commercial. We have private limos to take you to your commercial terminal. I mean, it's all quick, quick, quick. And so the beauty of this jet is that we put the fun back into flying. We put the fun back into traveling. Period. I mean, as Heidi said at the beginning, what is it that people really? It doesn't matter where you're going in the world. It doesn't matter what class of service you're in. You've got to schlep those bags to the airport. You've got to stand in line. You've got to get through TSA. You've got to get through all this, you know, on and off boarding process. I mean, you know, we generally, through all of our miles, we fly at the front of the bus. But it's still a hassle. And then there's always those commercial hiccups, you know. We're going to Delhi, but baggage happens to go down to Cape Town or something. You know, it's like craziness. So when we're flying privately, it's our own jet and our own crew. That jet doesn't go anywhere else for 23 days. It stays with us. We never lose our jet. The same with the regionals. That this is a dedicated jet to us for the entire time of the trip. The beauty of this is that we have a fully professional flight crew on board, but they become your friends. They love to see you every 4 days. They're reuniting with you. And funnily enough, they have a party too. You know, we leave destinations and they're dressed in the local costume of the destination. We have a couple of really important guys on this trip. namely a chef and a sous chef who come with us. Because we're only 30, up to 30 on our 757, we have a private dining room in the back of the jet. So the rear third of the jet is booths, basically, banquettes, that where we do our silver service luncheon. Remember I told you we always fly over lunch? So we might be taking off 11 in the morning. A couple of hours later, you know, we'll have champagne and canapes and the, whatever the celebration cocktail might be from that destination. Then we'll start a lunch service, because we've got a six-hour flight to go. So lots of fabulous dining in the air. We call it our Sky Lounge. And, you know, people honestly can't believe they're on board a plane, because you're flying around the world, there's no night flights, there's no jet lag involved, and you're getting this silver service with a chef and a sous chef who are actually preparing your a la carte dining on board the flight. What they've spent their 3 days in the destination doing is rustling up all the local key ingredients, freshest ingredients, to produce a magnificent lunch for you. You know, when you travel in some of the other groups that are out there, you know, they're traveling with 50, 80 people, there's no way if they can have chefs on board, because they can't prepare that many meals that are going to be a fine dining service. When we have from 26 to 30 people, it's easy. And then it's time for a snooze. It's time for a siesta, and we'll be landing in an hour after lunch. And of course, we have iPads on board. We have DVD players with movies on board. Everybody these days brings Kindles and brings their own iPad. So, you know, you're all set up to either do, you know, an hour's reading or so. But before you know it, we're at our next destination. So I think, you know, I can't say it enough, but even on these flights, clients say to us, you know, wow, you know, can't wait to be. Also, clients get to reunite with each other, because in the 2 days we're in destination, people are doing different things often, or in different, you know, doing different activities or in different groups. So suddenly the time they see each other is when we get back on the jet and they enjoy that lounge for, you know, catch-up drinks before lunch, or coffees after lunch, whatever they're looking to do. We go around the world with three of us. One of the reasons I love working with Heidi is this is a lady who doesn't sit behind a desk and design fabulous trips and then says, bye-bye, everybody, hope it's fun. This lady is accountable to every minute of that trip, because she's with us. Because when you do this in our business, you want to know that what you're designing for people to experience is exactly what we believe it is. Not that once they've gone, they're out of sight, out of mind. So there's a level of accountability with us that we are with you. And so often, while Heidi is running around with 1,000 details a day to make the day so fantastic, Jan and I have the most fortunate job of, instead of taking you around as a group of, say, 28, we're 14 with each of us, and we're doing all these wonderful activities, and on the second day, we're joining you for various, you know, things that you might be interested in. But it always is done on a personal level, on a small group personal level. And so, this is very, very important. It's why people, as I mentioned, Dr. Lambert, it's why they come back three times. We have a huge repeat in our life, and it's wonderful. I mean, it's a wonderful thing. And as I always say, you know, to other travel colleagues, it's, you know, it's the gift that keeps on giving. People are so sick and tired of what commercial travel is all about today, and it is hard. I mean, especially if you're going far away, and you know, when you're trying to deal with luggage and, you know, this just takes it all easy and makes it seamless and efficient. And, you know, some of these itineraries in paper are pretty complicated, but you don't know any of that. You're there for a fabulous, fabulous vacation. We're also able, you know, because we are this small group, we're able to open doors in places that wouldn't, you know, if you're just traveling as a couple or, say, two couples, you wouldn't be able to do it. But because we are, you know, 24, 26, 28 people, we can do these, what we call, you know, special events. So we do quite a few of them. They're usually surprises for you. In fact, we have a lot of the travel agents call us when clients come back and go, you didn't tell me they were going to meet a king cheetah in South Africa. I'm like, well, we don't tell you everything because we want it to be a surprise. So we love surprises along the way, and we do some pretty magnificent parties and gatherings along the way. We meet incredible people. And so I hope, you know, it's been a lot of information between Heidi and ourselves, but, you know, think about where you are in your life and what you're looking to do. You know, what is on your bucket list? What's on your dream list? Because if it's not available in the gold brochure, it might well be available on one of the luxury jet tour brochures. So, you know, we hope to see you with us. We'd love to. And thank you so much, all of you, for being with us tonight. Really appreciate it.